Back to Modded Minecraft Season 4, Episode 2. We are there, there to grab that back. Got a couple of things to up. There we go. So we've been over to the big house and we've grabbed a couple of things. We've made up a couple of blue beds, and I do have two. That is one of our mods working right there. For full list, we've got all loot drops, architectury, which is a library mod, better spawner control. But specifically, that is down stackables. Let's potions and that kind of thing stack. Now, enchanted armor and tools and that kind of things, unless they were the exact same durability and the exact same enchantments, do not stack. Unfortunately. But we've got a couple of furnaces over here going with some more iron. We did go ahead and head over to the cave over here and grab a couple of pieces of iron already for our iron armor and our iron tools. But now it is time for us to really head over, actually do some caving. So until we get some enchanted tools, we will not be doing a whole bunch of straight up mining. And most of the mining that we do will be on a they'll be labeled as a mining session for and attached to this series, but they won't be really in the episodes. I'll be editing a lot of them out. If we do go exploring and mining is added, it'll be a quick mining session. Or it will be a mining session wherein I'm adding. Where we're finding a dungeon or something like that. I was over here earlier. You'll see it from the other side here in a minute. There is a bit of a small cave right under here. Gotta be a little bit careful because it does have a big drop right beneath us. So we're trying to get a small drop. This drop. Like I said, there is a small cave right in through here. This was just trying to get into this section right here. And here we go. Doesn't have a whole lot of stuff, but what it does have is right here is a coal vein. And then, as you can see by the map, and there's a little bit of mobs around here earlier, it leads into another cave over there that we do need to go ahead and light up. But beneath of us, it does have a huge cave section over there. There's a small cave over there, and there's another huge cave over here. But the real reason we'll be doing more caving than mining is actually this right here. So it's a bit scattered right here. You can't really see it a whole lot. But one of the data packs we have is larger ore veins. And what it does is, as ores generate into the world, so you want it in your data pack folder. If you're going to use it, you want it in your data pack folder on load, world load. Otherwise, you'll get some chunks where it isn't loaded. It's not one of those that you can just take it in and take it out. I mean, you can, but the loads that you generate after you have loaded them up will not be like this. So, what it does is, as Minecraft runs its world generation system, One of the things it generates is the ores. What this data pack does is as it generates the ores, it makes, okay, so Minecraft labels this specific four spots to be iron ore veins. This one's going to be 6, this one's going to be 8, this one's going to be 12, and maybe this one's going to be a humongous 24 ore vein. It brings it all together. And so it makes ore veins rarer to find by quite a bit. It makes them bigger. So, for example, we are going to go ahead. So, another one of the mods that we are running. Is vein digging. I prefer the enchantment of this, honestly, just because of the way the enchantment is set up. Unfortunately, that mod is not updated yet, so we're using this. It works for the most part the same. It just uses more durability. The enchantment doesn't use one durability for, or doesn't use the same durability rates. The mod uses the same durability rate as if you had mined it. The enchantment has a different way that it does that. And so it can be a little bit nicer. But this works for the moment. But as you can see, this is a huge chunk. Why I made sure to bring plenty of iron with us, and we will be doing some teleporting back and forth between our base and where we are, and our cave over here. Just because some of these ore veins are going to be huge, and we are going to want to gather a whole bunch of them. Now the nice thing about this mod is it does work not just on ores. Some of them they have it set up so it specifically only works on ores. Some of them have it set up so it works on everything. And the one you just saw at work, where it dropped that diamond, is going to be dark mining. It has the opportunity of dropping another block or something like that. Along with the block that you actually dug up. In this case, it was a diamond. Looks like we got a couple of lapis while there. That kind of stuff. And it's not all the time, it's just a chance. Makes the resource gathering a little bit easier. Of course, until we actually find our first diamond ore, I can't use any of those diamonds, so they're nice. They're not useful quite yet. There we go. Like I said, that was a huge vein. Not all of them are that size. That first one that we did last episode was not that size. It was more of the length of a normal coal vein. This one was most definitely not. So, drop our crafting table real quick to make all of that into blocks of coal. And that gave us, we now have more than 64 blocks of coal. So we're going to be good on coal for a little while. Not forever, but for a good little while. This is a little bit nicer to get up and down with. The dark mining does make it depend on what you are digging up, mining up, etc. as to what it drops. So dirt is mainly going to give you crops, carrots, that kind of thing. Carrots and potatoes. There's still a chance of it dropping some other stuff, just not as big. Looking at the map, we've got some experience orbs that we need to go get real quick. There we go. So back over here to the iron ore that we have been mining out. Pretty big iron vein over here. So. And with this, we are going to really start our caving session. Most of it, you can check out the separate video that is just going to be the caving session on it. If you're really interested in what the caves all look like, we will be back for you to see what the end result of our caving session is going to be and how much we got. So, I will see you very shortly. And here we are. So, we'll be headed back to base and you can see the results of our mining here in a little bit. But we are doing a little bit of exploration, so looks like we have a small bit of cherry grove over here, and we are actually going to collect those trees. Our base probably won't be made completely of it, but I do want the wood type, just because I do have a couple of builds in mind, that I would like to use it in. And though it won't be our main building for the base, it will make a good accent block. Sorry about that. But this glitch seems to have been taken care of. Here we go. What? So we've got a cherry tree here. And I think we're gonna leave that one alone. It's got a beehive on it. And yes, you could just take it down. It wouldn't be that big of a deal, but I'm just gonna leave it up. Thought I saw another spot. Guess I didn't. We still got a good amount. Not much to complain about there. This? Oh my goodness! I wondered when I'd finally run into one, or how easy they'd be able to spot with the, Aurora Borealis, data pack installed. So, I'm not 100% sure, but the terracotta makes me think that this is going to be a Trail Ruins, that could just be the Aurora Borealis in the savannah, but the terracotta is in this patch, but it's not in that patch over there. I don't have a brush yet, so there's not a whole lot I can do with that, even if we did spot something. So we are just going to keep going, but I did mark it. And we will come back and explore that at a later date, if that is indeed what I think it is. So, but then again, this has terracotta in it too, so I'm not sure.